You brought the bright rays of light to the cloudy days. You were an inspiration for everybody. Oh, how we wish that you could stay.
Having a hard time saying goodbye to you. ever thought that my heart would break in two? People say it's gonna take time and all of the strength I can find, having a hard time saying goodbye to you. Saying goodbye, tears in my eyes. Saying goodbye, so hard to do. I never thought I'd be saying goodbye to you. I'm having a hard time letting the memories go.
Could drop that there. And collect some stuff in this bag there.
The 20, yes.
So there you go. Okay, hurry up to take care of it. Not in that one, yeah, that one. Don't take the whole one. Take the whole bag.
there for me, to love and care for me when skies were gray. Whenever I was down, you were always there to comfort me. And no one else can be what you have been to me. You will always be, you will always be the girl in my life for all time.
Mama, mama, you know I love you.
Ooh, you knew I love you.
Mama, mama, you're the queen of my heart. Your love is like tears from the stars.
Yes, it is.
Mama, I just want you to know.
Yes, it is. Oh, yes, it is. Yes, it is. Yes, it is. Oh,
you're always down for me, have always been around for me, even when I was bad. You've shown me right from my wrongs. Yes, you did. And you took up for me when everyone was down on me. You always did understand. You gave me strength to go on.
There were so many times looking back when I was so afraid. And then you come to me and say to me, I could face anything. And no one else can do what you've done for me. You'll always be.
I know
Yes.
Louise Reed had this to share about their interaction with our mother in the workplace. Miss L was an unassuming, caring, kind, loving, calm, peaceful, easygoing, dependable, and selfless individual. She was precise in her work and carried out her duties diligently and efficiently. She was always ready to help, even when not called upon to do so. She loved everyone she encountered at work or elsewhere, and everyone loved her as well. She had pet names for those closest to her. When she arrived at work, she would give a shout out to everyone to find out how they were doing. She loved to share whatever she had. During lunch break, a few of her closest friends would gather for some old jokes, and during that time, she enjoyed an exciting game of dominoes. She had a quiet disposition, never meddled or became involved in any fracas that might be happening. She experienced hurt, but was never one to render hurt in return. She was a disciplinarian, firm yet gentle. She also mastered the art of reverse psychology in dealing with issues. If she wanted you to change your behavior, she went about doing so in her own calm and artful way. As a wife, Elle did as the good book indicated. She submitted to her husband and respected him as the head of the household. She heeded his advice and loved him dearly. It was always a pleasure to hear them reminisce about the past and to see them celebrate the future. We recall how happy she would be when celebrating anniversaries. Their 50th wedding anniversary celebration in April 2018 was exceptionally special. Elle always made sure that her husband was well taken care of. Jacoby's clothes would be ironed and his food was always placed on the table ready for consumption. The only time he had to be worried about getting food was when mom was sick in bed. During these times, when he arrived home, mom would call from the bedroom, "Dayo, put food for daddy." And I would think to myself, "How is Mia? The food is all laid out. Daddy cannot just take what he wants." But I would have no choice but to oblige. To her four daughters, she was mama. She set a perfect example for all of us and raised us up to be respectable women. We were taught the importance of respecting others as well. She was a woman of principle. We were not supposed to stay out late or duive every and anywhere. We had to be mindful of our attire. Navels and backsides were not for exposure. She was not too impressed when Nadia jumped carnival for the first time. Tout backside ou de war, echilot salatour fin. Your backside is exposed and that panty is too thin, she told Nadia. But Nadia had already invested her money and told Mama she had dark stockings. She then attempted to cover up herself in a way more pleasing to our mother. Georgia recalled Mama giving us a lecture before sending us off to Assau Square one year. Mama told her girls to be back home by 7 p.m. At that point, Georgia, who was known to be very radical, said, 7 o'clock, Mama? Well, I'm not going anywhere. Nadia and I were more than happy to go with Doreen, who was not too impressed that she would have to assume responsibility for her two younger sisters. Mama was a staunch Catholic. She made it her business to be at church every Sunday, on some occasions Saturdays. God has blessed you for the week, she would say. We must go and give back and give thanks in the company of the community. Whenever she was ready for Mass on a Sunday, which was always half an hour before Mass, she would call out, hey, Georgia, Harriet, Nadia, let's go, I'm ready. Nadia, who was always the last to come down, would shout, Mama, it's not even 10 to yet. Mama would always remind Nadia that she was always punctual for work and needed to practice the same for church. I remember missing church on two consecutive Sundays. When Mama realized that I was not getting ready, she gave me a stern look and said, "That's the second Sunday in a row that you are missing church. I do not like that." Well, by the time my mother was ready to be driven to church, I was dressed and ready to go. Yes, I read between the lines and did not want this hanging over my head. Once you did not see Mama at Mass, you would know she was ill, although sometimes she dragged herself to go. As she did on Mother's Day this year, her last celebration in church, she had already begun to feel unwell, but had missed service the Sunday before. We had to be decently attired for church. Garments were not to be short, and arms had to be covered. She did not like strappy dresses or shawls too much. "Now we're tutabab, wow. I could see all underneath your arms," she would say. "You are going to the house of the Lord, not to a party." She was a member of the choir, the Foster Mothers and Fathers group, and later the Babonneau Mothers and Fathers group. She was recognized as Mother of the Year by the Babonneau Mothers and Fathers Central Committee in 2010. She enjoyed accompanying the members of the Holy Name Society at rallies across the island. She was a regular at prayer meetings held at Calvary in the earlier years. She was at Kubaril every first Saturday with her grandchildren. Everyone knew her as the lady who encouraged her children to offer prayer intentions. She believed in service. She encouraged her granddaughters to participate in the choir and her grandson to play the drums. Each of us received our personal missal and hymn book as gifts from her. Nothing ticked her off more than when someone came to church empty-handed and stood with hands folded and mouths shut. You had to participate in the Mass to enjoy it. She enjoyed singing in the choir and could be seen from the congregation raising her hands in praise and moving to the sounds of the music. The song "Glory to God in the Highest" comes to mind at this point. She had many songbooks, song sheets, leaflets from various churches and activities in storage. No wonder Teacher Christina always called on her when she was trying to locate a copy of a particular song. Her position in the choir loft gave her a good view of the congregation and used it to her advantage. On a few occasions, she would spot her niece Gail coming in and would reprimand her at the end of the Mass for being late. "Why are you so late? You must make an effort to be early." Mama believed in receiving all the blessings of the Mass from beginning to end. She had to arrive before the priest and clergy entered the church. She was a prayer woman. She followed the Masses on ENTN and Trinity TV regularly. She said the rosary often and would pray frequently. She impressed upon us the importance of praying for people who did not know as well. We did not know as well. "Everyone has crosses to bear," she would say. "When you think you have it bad, some people are going through worse than you." She never complained, not even when she was in pain, because she would say, "Everybody must bear their lot in life." She did not let it keep her down. She taught us to take ownership and set examples for us in that regard. When we moved to Jiwakaku approximately 31 years ago, she organized prayer meetings in the community. She maintained the surroundings by planting flowers in the area. She loved flowers. She was very tidy. Mama maintained an interest in our education, in the education of her children. She visited teachers regularly to follow up on our performance at school. Of course, she never went empty-handed and would always bring them fruits and vegetables. She always gave little. She always gave the little that she had. When going to visit someone, she would remind us to walk with something for them. We would not dare go empty-handed. Mama always told us how proud she felt whenever the four of us were in the company of her and had to affirm that we were her daughters. She was proud of our accomplishments. We were happy to have such a mother and realized the benefits of her counsel as we got older and wiser. Her grandchildren reminisced about her tender touch, which soothed them when they were hurting. "Come, let Mama rub that for you," she would tell them. But those hands, her fingers to be exact, were to be used to discipline them as well. A quick grab and twist of their skin would leave them crying in pain, but the lesson was received. Yes, she was a master pincher. Your skin would be left sore for a while. She was constantly teaching, advising, and correcting them. Mama was known as a MacGyver of the family. She was creative and could fix a plan and could come up with a plan and fix something with available items within her reach in minutes. Once you saw the results, you would know her hands touched it. To her extended family, she also served as a mother. She helped raise her niece Lucretia and deceased nephew Trevor. Her niece Etty recalled Mama taking care of her and giving sound advice. The children of the deceased sister Almonita described her as a second mother. She always looked after them and brought them goodies whenever she visited the family. She also helped their mother sew the latest garments for them. We all enjoyed her pemmies, coconut tablets, and fish cakes. She would whip up a fish cake batter within minutes, and she would always have the essentials on hand. Saltfish, chives, and you know all that, and you know all too well not to throw away the saltfish water. Every Christmas, she would bestow gifts of plaited bread for various people. She kept in touch with all from time to time. She was always opening her little red diary in search of a number. It has been a while since I have not seen or heard from this person, she would say. She was diligent in visiting and spending time with her friends, the sick and the elderly, and she would never visit empty-handed. She would always inquire about the person and likewise their family. Our mom was described as a good dancer. She always loved squashions and was always happy to accompany her brothers on such limes to Olio and Oshase. She would dance the night away and always wore the latest style and fashion, sewn by her skilled and able hands. She was respected by everyone in her family. Her siblings confided in her and welcomed her advice, even as their youngest sister. In measured, quiet tones, she said what she had to, and all would listen. There is strength in quiet too. There is no need to be loud or aggressive to get things done. Not many people saw her angry. She fostered and maintained great relationships with her family, in-laws, Peace Corps volunteers, friends, tenants, neighbors. She was organized. She kept invitations, leaflets, and records of birthdays and general anniversaries. She never forgot a date or activity. She always called her nephews and nieces here and abroad to extend greetings and would send out gifts and cards. Mom will be remembered for her quiet strength, her faith and love for God. Her genuinely nice, kind, considerate, caring, beautiful personality for her radiant smile, for her laughter, for her humility. There was no air about her. She was very unassuming. We were always referred to as her patients when we were sick and were treated as such. How are you feeling this morning, my patient? Are you ready for some breakfast? You need to eat if you want to get better. Would you like to go to the doctor? It was such a pleasure giving back to this amazing woman when she became our patient during the 2 weeks that she became critically ill. It was a difficult period for us. Our days and nights were consumed by her, but we accomplished our duties as caregivers with joy and without complaint. It was easy to give out what she gave back to us, and we supported each other. She was always so grateful, and this is one of the things we appreciated about her. Realizing our efforts, she expressed her gratitude for our love and care. We are happy our mom passed knowing that she was loved by all of us, and she always expressed her love in words and actions. When asked how much she loved us, she would respond, "A lot, a lot, a lot, a lot, a lot, a lot." Our dear mother was ready to go home. She uttered many things during her time of illness, things we only picked up on after she was gone. "I want to go home," she would say. "I want to go upstairs." Even before her illness, she made no bones about indicating her readiness to meet her maker. She did not want to live on in pain and suffering and become a burden to her family. Her wish was indeed granted. I could hear God saying repeatedly, "Whatever you did for one of the least of these brothers and sisters of mine, you did it for me." Mama attended to the hungry and thirsty, extended open arms to strangers and visitors, and visited the sick. She was indeed a good and faithful servant. She was blessed, and we honestly believe her reward will be great in heaven. By her life, Elle has confirmed that the most important things in life are faith, family, and friends. Let us try to live and love as she did. The Lord has better plans for you, Mama. Rest in perfect peace. Thank you.
Grateful, prayerful, patient, unassuming, committed, amazing, supportive, modest, faithful, patient, loving woman of God, our L. A woman of faith, a woman who loved her family and were committed to her friends. What a beautiful example of how we should live. And so because we all gathered here giving testament to what her family members shared, we are all going to join together in this celebration of her life. As the family members get ready to go down to the entrance with the celebrants, Father Celestine and Deacon Tony, and assisted by Brother Festus, we are all going to continue to follow and to participate. Thank you everybody for being here. As I said earlier, we are still following the COVID-19 protocols. And so we encourage persons to be very vigilant and to follow the social distancing and sanitizing protocols and to keep your masks on. Thank you.
To the seashore, need a searching for, there is not a one, desiring only that I should follow. Oh Lord, with the eyes set upon, gently smiling, you have spoken my name. All I long for, I have found by the water. At your side, I will seek on the shore. At your side, I will seek the shore. At your side, I will seek the shore.
Good afternoon, sisters. Good afternoon, brothers. I welcome everyone on this special day. We celebrate the life of our sister, Maria Alan Lucille Joseph. It is the will of the Lord that she will be with him today. And it is our own obligations and duties to say farewell and goodbye, beloved sister, friend, and mother of all of us. As we gather this afternoon, let us make it as spiritual as possible as we give thanks to God for a life well lived. And so I invite all of us as we pray in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Praise be the God, our Father, of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies and the God of all consolation. He comforts us all in all our afflictions and thus enables us to comfort those who are in trouble with the same consolation we have received from him. Blessed be God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Blessed be God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ.
And I bless the body of our sister. Can we remove the flower, please? Her baptism, of which St. Paul writes, all of us who we are baptized into Christ's death, we are baptized into his death. By baptism into his death, we were buried together with Jesus, so that just as Christ Jesus was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live a new life. For if we have been united with him by likeness to his death, so shall we be united with him by likeness to his resurrection. Marie, on the day of your baptism, you put on Christ. In the day of Christ's coming, may you be clothed with glory through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Loving God and Father, hear our humble prayer this afternoon and be merciful to your daughter, our sister, Marie, whom you have called from this life to yourself. Welcome Hannah, Lord, into the company of your saints in the kingdom of light and peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We join the family as they process with the candles. Carry your candle.
She's been robbed and lied to, still holds a candle without a flame.
Whose hearts are
blazing, let's raise our candle, light up the sky, pray to our Father, in the name of Jesus, make us a reason.
Open up an entry into eternity. We humbly beseech you, Lord, by the grace of your mercy, you may command the name of your servant and our sister, Mary Alma Lucelle Joseph, to be among the saints, to be inscribed in the book of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns within the unity of the Holy Spirit, our God, forever and ever.
Amen.
The first reading, a reading from Job chapter 19, verses 1-23 to 27 is our first reading for today. Let us listen.
Job said, would that these words of mine were written down, inscribed on some monument, with iron chisel and engraving tool, cut into the rock forever. This I know, that my avenger lives, and he, the last, will take his stand on earth. After my awakening, he will set me close to him, and from my flesh I shall look on God. He whom I shall see will take my part. These eyes will gaze on him and find him not aloof. The word of the Lord.
Thank you, sister. We respond singing, "The Lord is my shepherd, and I will trust in you."
Thank you.
shepherd of God's words. He makes me lie in pastures green. He leads me by the still waters. His goodness restores my soul. And I will trust in you.
I will trust in you.
And I will trust.
I will trust. I will trust in you.
For your endless mercy follows me. Your goodness will lead me home. He guides my ways in righteousness, and he anoints my head with oil, and my mouth is overflows with joy. I feast on his glory.
Trust in you.
And I will trust.
I will trust.
In you.
I will trust in you.
For your endless mercy follows me. Your goodness will lead me home.
And though I walk.
Proclamation comes from 1 John chapter 3, verses 14 to 16. Let us listen.
We have passed out of death and into life, and of this we can be sure, because we love our brothers. If you refuse to love, you must remain dead. To hate your brother is to be a murderer. And murderers, as you know, do not have eternal life in them. This has taught us to love, that he gave up his life for us, and we too ought to give up our lives for our brothers. This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you, brother. Our gospel proclamation, Bon Dieu nous a glorifié. As we prepare to listen to the gospel from John.
si nou ka wè mesyon pou ka wò nou ki la vi etenè. Bon Diye, nou pa glorifye Jezi, nou ka wè mesyon pou ka wò nou ki la vi etenè. Le aj arrive pou nou tout wè pati, touche Diye nou et Jésus, nous pas oui, mission pour parole, nous qui la vie éternelle. Oh Dieu, nous pas glorifier Jésus, nous pas oui, mission pour parole, nous qui la vie éternelle.
Nous l'on be with you. Proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory be to thee, O Lord.
John's Gospel, chapter 12, verses 23 to 28. Jesus said to his disciples, "Now the hour has come for the Son of Man to be glorified. I tell you most solemnly, unless a wheat grain falls on the ground and dies, it remains only a single grain. But if it dies, it yields a rich harvest. Anyone who loves me, anyone who loves his life, loses it. Anyone who hates his life in this world will keep it for the eternal life. If a man serves me, he must follow me. Wherever I am, my servant will be there too. If anyone serves me, my Father will honor him. Now my soul is troubled. What shall I say? Father, save me from this hour. But it is for this very reason that I have come to this hour. Father, glorify your Son. Glorify your name. A voice came from heaven. I have glorified it, and I will glorify it again." Friends in Christ, brothers and sisters, the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to the Lord Jesus Christ.
Because he lives.
I think we are the most fortunate persons to be here this afternoon to give thanks with a grateful heart. If not for anything, this funeral is supposed to take place yesterday. But we all know the reason why we are not able, and that is the storm. My brothers and sisters, sometimes we don't know exactly what God do for us. Sometimes we take a lot of things for granted. The storm have come and passed. I don't know how many of us felt it. Maybe we would have taken it as just like one of those storms. It's the same kind of storms that generate and increase and multiply in speed that in 2019 leveled the whole of Dominica. Up to today, they are still recovering from it. Why they were still recovering it, from it, the people of Bahamas. So when we look and we face situations like that, I think really it should be a moment of sober reflection. It's not a time to say, oh, it was a storm, it has passed, nothing happened, or this or that. Rather, it is a time to ask yourself and ask myself, why is it so? Why didn't it happen like it happened in the Dominica? Why didn't we experience what we experienced in 2010 and so many areas, so many other places, both in the America and other places, hurricanes have devastated. So I think really we St. Lucians, we at least at this moment, we must be one of the most grateful people. And being grateful means that really you are a lover of God. And today we are celebrating a woman who loves God. we are celebrating an epitome of Christian virtue. We are celebrating a woman who understood what it means to give thanks with her life, with her resources, with her family, with her church. We are celebrating our beloved sister, whom it pleased the Lord to take away to himself. And on that note, all of us here in Good Shepherd, we are all mourning. Mourning not just like anyone, but like Christians. And on that note, how we say to the family of the Josephs and the Toussaints, that you, on behalf of the entire parishioners, accept our utmost profound condolence and sympathy. Your loss is not your loss, it is our loss. And we all are in the same boat of sharing in your sorrows, in your pain. And I just want to congratulate you all for such a steadfast love, for your perseverance, for your lovely care to your mom. Throughout this period, this couple of weeks, she was down. You gave her your very best to make sure that really she felt comfortable in the midst of the pains. She never felt lonely. She never, of course, even in her pain, she tried to conceal it because of her great love for your children. She didn't want to really show it up. So as we mourn this afternoon, as you say our final farewell and our goodbye to our beloved sister, I say to you, take courage. For indeed, death is something that is certain. Death is something that is destined for each and every living creature. It is her turn today. It may be my own today, tomorrow. Who next? Who knows when? So in the midst of our sorrows and lost, which is normal and natural, because it's not easy, my dear brothers and sisters, unless you have imparted directly someone you love, someone that cares, someone you know, she has made a great, mighty impression in your life. Sometimes it's easy to preach on someone's own funeral, but when it really, really touches you, you get to know what it means to lose a lovely one. But even in the midst of it all, God is the strength and comfort of those who call upon his name. So I thank God for your lives. I thank God for your faith. This faith, of course, which you was betrothed to you through her motherly love and care and concern for you. Listening to the eulogy this afternoon, I think it captures everything I know about her. But one thing I know, that only she always sit there every Sunday. Every Sunday. Any Sunday she cannot come, she will come on Saturday evening. And when she comes, she doesn't come alone. She comes with a whole family. Today, Good Shepherd Parish is losing one of the signs of what it means to be a Christian mother, which is very, very rare today. I can count how many families I can say these are Catholic family in this parish. So it's not just your loss, it's our own loss. But we are not going to mourn like St. Paul advised us in 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 13. We are not going to mourn or cry like those who don't have faith. The faith for which she had built up her home, her family, enables us to know that only even though we mourn and lament the loss of her life, that is not the end of her, that she have gone to her Lord and her God to receive that reward for which she worked and labored all her life. That reward for which she hoped upon, that made her, even when pains and sickness were there, they were not able to incapacitate her from serving her God. What an epitome of virtue. What an exemplary life. What an experience. So this afternoon, I felt that it is important to also remind us as Christians that we have an example in the life of our sister. Her faith saw her through this period of pains, all through the time she was sick. Fortunately, I was able to visit her twice. The first day I visited her, I didn't know to the extent her sickness was. I didn't know to what extent, but really, when I looked at her, of course, she smiled. And she put in all her energy and her strength to respond to the prayers. And then when I gave her communion, you saw a different new person. It was as if the pain, everything had disappeared. She struggled to get up. Her children helped her. She was raising her hand and praising the Lord. But deep down her, my dear sisters and brothers, is only those who know what it means to suffer from the pain of cancer know what she was going through. But even in the midst of it all, cancer wouldn't stop her from praising God. What about you, my brother, my sister? Is there anything in your life that stops you from praising and glorifying God today, even as a healthy person? Do you have other gods that really will prevent you from giving thanks to God? Have you chosen another pathway that has redefined your priorities and your good in life? What is it that really can stop you from praising God? St. Paul reminds us in his letter to the Romans chapter 8 from verse 31 and following, who can separate us from the love of Christ? Is it sickness? Is it hunger? Is it what to wear, what to eat? Is it the devil? Nothing. Nothing that exists, nothing yet to exist, can separate us from the love God has lavished upon us. And what is this great love? It's a love we hear Jesus talking about, asking his Father, glorify your Son. And a voice from heaven said, I have glorified it already, and I will glorify it again. How is God glorifying the voice, the Son again? He glorified the Son again in you and I. Each day, we live a life of glory unto the Lord. Each day, we make our earnest effort to live that life of virtue, having God as our first and last, our Alpha and Omega, irrespective of every other thing in this life, knowing that really everything in this life is all vanity. And one day awaits each and every one of us. So that even if I'm to work hard to be a millionaire in this life, if I'm to work hard to have all it takes in this life, if I do not have Christ, I have nothing. I have lost everything. Because at the time of death, the defining moment in your life, which must surely come, you discover that there's nothing in this life X can give you that kind of consolation. There's nothing in this life that can really encourage you to really hold on, even when that pain is biting deep down your flesh, eating you up. The only thing that can help you in the midst of everything to know that really all is not lost is not the best doctor you have. It's not the money you are able to afford to pay your insurance and do all that. It is only that name, that wonderful name, Jesus, which is above every other name, whether you like it or not, whether you believe it or not. Brother, sister, when that day comes, when that hour comes, you will get to know. You see, we can't listen. We pray the Hail Mary and people accuse us. They pray to Mary. We don't pray to Mary. But the last part of that prayer, recognize the Father, at the moment of death, every one of us, we need the angels. We need all the heavenly hosts to help us because that transition is never easy. First of all, it's never easy because we don't want to live this life. We don't want to be detached. We don't want to be cut off from our loved ones, from all our wealth and everything. And secondly, the devil is there at that last moment of your life, dragging and trying to claim your soul to himself. And the angels are out there fighting back. So we can say, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. So important. And I want to really let this opportunity be an opportunity for you think about death, not with fear. Think about death, planning and knowing that really one day it must surely come. And when it shall come, you don't need to be afraid. God will send you that divine consolation. He will send you the help from heaven to help you to bear whatever it is. So that really, having defined your own life, when it finally comes, you will be among the number, rejoicing and singing and praising. Just like in Revelation, hallelujah will be our heavenly song. They sing and they bow and praise God all the days. And that is our desire. And that is the will of God for each and every one of us. So this afternoon as we celebrate, we pray and ask God to receive the soul of her, of his daughter, our sister, who did her very best in this life to know him, love him, and serve him. Who did everything, not just knowing and loving and serving him, but was able to raise her family up to follow in the footsteps of the Lord. And I just want to read a few verses from this chapter for every one of us, because sometimes, some of us, we don't even know what we are doing to our children. We think that really we don't want to disturb them, we don't want to trouble them, we want them to have the best of life. I just want you to listen to this scriptural passage. It's not a common scripture that we read often. This comes from Ecclesiastes chapter 30. From verse 1 to 13, it says, "A father who loves his son, we weep him often. A father who loves his son, we weep him often, so that he can be proud of him later. If a son is disciplined, he will be of some use, and his father can boast of him to his friends." He'll be proud of his son to his friends. "A man who gives good guidance to his son can not only take pride in him among his friends, but he can make his enemies jealous. While the father is alive, the sight of his son makes him happy. While a mother is alive, the sight of her daughters makes her happy. And when he dies, he has no regret at all. He is not really dead, because his memory lives in his sons and his daughters. He has left someone to take vengeance on his enemies and to return the favors he often has from his friends." Then the next verse says, "But a man who spoils his son, we have to bandage his own wound. His heart will stop every time he hears a shout in the street. Because of what? An untamed host is going to be stubborn, and an undisciplined son is no different. If you pamper your child and play with him, he will be a disappointment and a source of grief. Laugh with him now, and one day you will have to cry over him, grinding your teeth in regret. Don't give him freedom while he is young, and don't overlook what he does wrong. Beat him if you must beat him while he is still a child, and make him respect your authority. If you don't, he will be stubborn and disobedient and can cost you nothing but sorrow. So discipline your son and give him work to do, or else he will be an embarrassment to you." We celebrate our sister for the discipline she was able to inculcate in her children, waking them up even when they don't want to go to church. It's not a waste. I hear some parents say, "Oh, I didn't come with my child because he was sleeping, or he was out the whole night partying, so I didn't want to disturb him." Good and fine. That's okay. But really, the truth of the matter, really, today we hear psychologists preaching why we should not touch a child or not do this and do that. And what many of us don't know, the woman, an American woman who started that policy, her son died of suicide. And no man, no mother, no father want to experience that. So as Christians, as Catholics, the church invites us to learn to train our children in the word of the Lord, so that when they grow up, they will not depart from it. Our sister had done her own part, and the angels in heaven are rejoicing, and her reward already made very, very clear for her. We pray that the Lord may grant her eternal rest and strengthen the family and help us who live to even do better than she did, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Shall we stand and bring our petitions to our loving God and Father?
We invite the family members. Marisa, Yannick, Charlene, Ajani, and Kishma.
My dear brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church, confident that God hears the voice of those who trust in him. We join our prayers and petitions to him for the repose soul of our sister and for all the dead and the living alike.
After each intercession, we sing, "Someone's praying, Lord, Kumbaya."
Dear Lord, we pray for all in the church who have been called to the religious life. Our Pope Francis, our bishops, priests, deacons, and nuns. May they be granted the wisdom and humility to allow them to guide all members of the church towards the true light of Christ. We thank you for their selfless dedication and remind us to always provide our support for them when needed. Lord, hear our prayer.
Somebody's praying, Lord, Kumbaya. Somebody's praying, Lord, Kumbaya.
Prayer for the nation. Dear Lord, you are the rock on which this nation was founded. We ask that you reclaim this land for your glory and dwell among your people. Bless and guide all those whose duty is it to serve and lead us. Grant them the wisdom, compassion, and humility to make good decisions. May they also be inspired by your example of Jesus to serve your people in a spirit of selflessness, fairness, and humility. Lord, hear our prayer.
Somebody's praying, Lord, Kumbaya. Somebody's praying, Lord, Kumbaya.
Prayer for the sick. Dear Lord, hear our prayer for the sick members of this community and for all who are in need. May they receive comfort from God's presence, assistance from medical treatment, and understanding and support from all of us. Send your healing spirit upon them and bless all of those who care for them. The word of the Lord.
Somebody's praying, Lord, Kumbaya. Somebody's praying, Lord, Kumbaya.
Prayer for the family. Dear Lord, we pray for the family and friends who love Lucelle Joseph, that they may be comforted in their grief. Give them the strength to continue to live by your example. With the love and kindness she gave to all who knew her, help us to accept her death and find comfort in knowing she is at peace in your care. Lord, hear our prayer.
Somebody's praying, Lord, help me. Somebody's praying, Lord, help me.
Prayer for the deceased. Dear Lord, we entrust our dear Lucelle Joseph into your loving arm. We thank you for the gift of her life and for her love for us all. Please remember the good she has done and forgive any sin she has committed. Welcome her now in your heavenly home where she will know peace and happiness forever. Lord, hear our prayer.
Somebody's praying, Lord, help her. Somebody's praying, Lord, help her.
And in baptism, our sister Maria received the light of Christ. Loving God and Father, we ask you, scatter the darkness now and lead her over to the waters of death. We pray to the Lord.
Somebody's praying, Lord, Jambaya. Somebody's praying, Lord, Jambaya.
Our sister was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome her now, Lord, into the halls of the heavenly banquet. We pray to the Lord.
Somebody's praying, Lord, Jambaya. Somebody's praying, Lord, Jambaya.
As we assembled here in faith and in confidence to pray for the reposed soul of our sister, may the Lord strengthen our hope in the resurrection, that we may live in the expectation of Jesus' coming. We pray to the Lord.
Somebody's praying, Lord.
In a moment of silence in our hearts, let us turn to the Lord, asking for the grace to know that which is the most important, to prepare for our own death, and to give us the grace to follow. We entrust the soul of our sister through the Immaculate Heart of Mary, that our Blessed Mother Mary may intercede and pray for her as we say, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer, Jesus Christ, and the voices of your people gathered in prayer this afternoon. Forgive the sins of your daughter or sister who have gone to sleep in Christ, and grant her a place in your kingdom of light and peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Thank you, brothers and sisters, for the intercessions. We now go on to the collection, which is part of our service, our Mass. And during this time, we encourage you to give generously. And we sing, We Will Magnify.
Mm-hmm.
as we continue to give our gifts of treasure, and we continue to present these, saying, take into your hands, my Lord.
This afternoon may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands.
For the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church. Dear near, O Lord, we pray to your servant Maria, on whose funeral day we offer you this sacrifice of conciliation, so that should any stain or sin have clung to her, or any human fault have affected her, it may by your loving gaze be forgiven and wiped away. Grant this through Christ our Lord. Thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty, our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for you are faithful, Lord, life is chain not ended. Amen. This earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And
and so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we are cleansed.
Papa, mon Dieu, nous sait.
And rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and the working of the Holy Spirit, you give light to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather the people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your most holy name. Therefore, Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought you for consecration, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said a blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more given thanks. He gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you wait to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed apostles and all glorious martyrs, St. John the Baptist, and all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, Robert, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and entire people your Son has gained for your own. Listen graciously, Father, to the prayers of this family whom you summoned before you this afternoon. In your compassion and merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant and your daughter, Maria Lucelle, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. When from the earth, he will raise up in the flesh those who have died, and transform our lonely bodies after the pattern of his own glorious body. To all our beloved brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you and their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. When you will wipe away every tear from our eye. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages and praise you without end. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, through whom you bestowed on the world all that is good. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, almighty Father, forever and ever. Amen. 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 Divine teaching, we dare to sing.
Let's all stand as we raise our hands, singing the prayer of our salvation, the Our Father.
In our days, that by the help of your mercy, Lord, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and at the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give to you. Look not on our sins, Lord. Look not on our weaknesses, our foolishness and our weaknesses and mistakes, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen.
the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us make a sign of peace to one another. Peace be with you. And sisters, behold Jesus, who has promised us that he is the bread of life. Whoever eats his flesh and drinks his blood, even if he die, he will raise him up on the last day. Behold the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say your word. May the body and blood of Jesus bring us that receive it eternal life. Amen.
During communion, we sing out my soul to the Lord.
O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine.
Let us pray. Run, we pray, Almighty God, that your servant Mary and Lucelle, who today has journeyed from this world, may by this sacrifice be cleansed and freed from sin, and so receive the everlasting joys of the resurrection. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. During the signing of the register, we ask, of course, the witnesses to come forward. Bathazar Joseph, Paulina George Joseph, Georgia, Doreen Jean-Baptiste, and Michael Patterson Tousses, Sr. We sing Hail, we have a special rendition by our brother Trevon St. Omer.
Thank you.
separate ways. Let us take leave of our beloved sister. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself.
During this time, we sing Gentle Woman.
Just whisper.
Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
Saints of God, come to her aid, hasten to meet her, angels of the Lord.
Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. And may angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham.
Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her.
Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
Let us pray into your hands, Father of mercies. We commend our sister, Maria Lucelle, in the sight, in the sure and certain hope, that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks, Lord, for the many blessings which you bestowed upon her in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with you and with all the saints in heaven. Merciful Lord, turn towards us who are still alive and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurance of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our beloved sister forever in your kingdom of peace and light. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. May choirs of angels welcome you and lead you to the bosom of Abraham, and where Lazarus is poor no longer, may you find eternal rest through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And so, my dear brothers and sisters, in peace, let us take the body of our sister to her place of final rest.
As we come to the end of our celebration in this church, we continue to thank you on behalf of the family for joining in this wonderful celebration for Women of Faith. Our recessional hymn, "This World Is Not My Home."
Treasures I lay down somewhere beyond the blue. I'm not going to be able to do that. His faith or her faith in me will never suffer eternal death. Lord Jesus, you wept at the death of your friend Lazarus. Comfort us all in our sorrow. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayers.
Lord, hear our prayers.
You raise the dead to life. Give your servant, our sister, eternal life. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayers.
You promised paradise to the thief who repented. Bring your servant, our sister Lucelle, to the joys of heaven. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Our sister Lucelle was washed clean in baptism and anointed with the oil of salvation. Give her fellowship with your saints. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayers.
She was nourished with your body and blood. Grant her a place at the table in your heavenly kingdom. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Comfort us, O Lord, in our sorrows at the death of our sister. Lucelle, let our faith be our consolation and eternal life our hope. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray. Lord, listen to our prayers for our sister Lucelle. As she always desired to do your will, so in your mercy, forgive whatever wrong she may have done. By her Christian faith, she was united with all your believing people. Now, in love and mercy, Lord, give her a place with your angels and saints. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns between the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
May her soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God,
rest in peace. Amen.
Eternal life grant unto her, O Lord, amen. And let that through her maternal intercession.
Tell us, move the Lord, if your eyes set upon me, Yeah. Come great! Spirit. Hold it down in the end. Sasa, just bring it down a little bit and so it'll fit flat. Just bring all of them down a little bit more. A little bit flat. Yeah. Just bring them down. Right. Yeah, that's enough. Yeah. Right. Pull the others down. Still have to bring it down. No, that one will fit.
Put your knife instead.
Try it now, Sasa. Try it now, Sasa.
Ça va, vous êtes poussé, ça va bon? Vous êtes arraché, là, maintenant?
Ok, c'est ça.
Ah, ok. C'est ça. Ah, ok. C'est ça. Ah, ok. C'est ça. Ah, ok. C'est ça. Ah, ok. C'est ça. Ah, ok. C'est ça. Ah, ok. C'est ça. Ah, ok. C'est ça. Ah, ok. C'est ça. Ah, ok. C'est ça. Ah, ok. C'est ça. Ah, ok. C'est ça. Ah, ok. C'est ça. Ah, ok. C'est ça. Ah, ok. C'est ça. Ah, ok. C'est ça. Ah, ok. C'est ça. Ah, ok. C'est ça. Ah, ok. C'est ça. Ah, ok. C'est ça. Ah, ok. C'est ça. Ah, ok. C'est ça. Ah, ok. C'est ça. Ah, ok. C'est ça. Ah, ok. C'est Yeah. Thank you. Anything, and no one else yet to know.
Nothing is like food to my soul. Never gonna go a day without you.
Love to